I'm going to tell you a story, a true story. A child is being sexually abused. We'll call her Maria. Maria's abuser is taking pictures while he abuses her and then sharing these images and videos onto a content hosting platform, hiding in plain sight among hundreds of millions of other images and videos. But this particular platform doesn't accept this. This platform uses Thorn's Safer product. It uses Safer's Child Sexual Abuse Material, or CSAM classifier, to find images and videos that could show a child in an active abuse situation. And one day, the classifier alerts them. They've got a hit. So they go to work, and here's what they find. A user has shared over 2,000 new abuse files. It's clear a child is being abused. So they flag the case to law enforcement, who launch an investigation. And the child in that content, she is found. Maria is found. An arrest is made, a recovery is complete, and for Maria, a brighter future emerges. This isn't just a story. This is reality. This is the gravity of our work. We as technologists, we have the power to end a child's real-life nightmare. Our challenge, how do we find them and stop the cycle of trauma? The answer to these questions are buried in haystacks of data. So then, what's that right magnet to find that needle in a haystack? The answer is complex, and an essential part of it lies with machine learning. According to the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, in 2022, they received over 88 million files of suspected child sexual abuse reported to them by online platforms. Now, these aren't just files. These are kids, kids who desperately need help. Think about it. With 88 million files and even just 1 second of review per file, that's going to be almost 3 years of nonstop review. I don't want any kid to have to wait that long to get help. We are a nonprofit that builds technology to combat child sexual abuse at scale. AWS is our preferred cloud provider in this work. We leverage AWS services to power our machine learning tools. I have dedicated my career to defending children from sexual abuse. So I can tell you with confidence here today, machine learning AI, it does make a difference. We built Safer. So we built Safer, our all-in-one tool to detect, review, and report child sexual abuse material. Safer uses hashing and matching to find known abuse material, content that's already been verified by an analyst, and the classifier to find new abuse material. My team at Thorn, we built the classifier to act as that powerful magnet to find new child sexual abuse material at scale. Now, when we first started building the classifier back in 2019, there was already active research on the use of convolutional neural networks for detecting child sexual abuse. But we needed a classifier that went beyond research, something that worked at a production scale. When we build a classifier, we follow the CRISP-DM process. As you can see, it's really all about the data. But within this broader framework, we had to overcome a key hurdle. This data is illegal. Child sexual abuse material is illegal. You can't store it in the same places or the same way as other content. So the solution was to collaborate. We invested in hardware installed on-site at organizations with the legal right to house this data, training the classifier on-prem, and then using Amazon's ECR to distribute that trained model to end users. So we've got this critical training infrastructure in place, and now we can build, starting with data prep. We use techniques like perceptual hashing to deduplicate the data set, ensuring that there's no overlap between the training, testing, and validation sets. We use Amazon S3 to store our non-abuse material. And this data is just as important as the abuse material for training our classifier. Now, model training via remote access to an on-prem solution, it's got its challenges. It can be slow and opaque. So we use Amazon EC2 and EKS to do R&D with benign data first, debugging and fixing any issues we may find in our training pipeline before training on-prem. In the machine learning AI lifecycle of develop, deploy, maintain, that maintain part is key because models get stale and models have bias. So what this means is monitoring performance and regular retrains. What's our performance holistically? And then drilling down, is our model better at classifying abuse material of lighter skin or darker skin children? What kind of trends are we hearing from users about false positives and false negatives? Because to fix a problem, we have to first know what that problem is. Then we balance our data sets, adjust the model weights, refresh our training data set with new images, and retrain. Now, AWS powers our user feedback. We have an API in our AWS-hosted Safer services where users can submit false positives to incorporate back into our training. These false positives are often the most valuable negative examples that we have because they allow us to do targeted retrains and improve performance on data in the wild. Now, none of this hard work that I talked about matters at all if you can't get the classifier into the hands of the users. So effective model deployment is key, working collaboratively with engineering and product to find the right solution for the user's needs. And when I say effective deployment, I'm specifically thinking privacy forward and human in the loop. I am proud and thankful for how Thorn's engineers deploy the classifier in a way that the customer has full control over when and how the content is reviewed and reported. Because the classifier, it acts as that powerful magnet, but it should be a human making the final call on what gets reported. Now, we are all here today because we want to build something that has impact. So what's that impact look like for Thorn and our partners? It looks like the outcome of the true story I told you earlier. A child gets her life back. It looks like over 2.8 million potential files of child sexual abuse found via Safer. It looks like constant innovation. This month, we launched Safer Essential, an API-based solution for quick detection of known child sexual abuse material. This is a future where every child is free to simply be a kid. And everything we build at Thorn, it's to get to that future. But that technology by itself is never going to be enough. Having impact requires all of us to work together. Content hosting platforms, law enforcement, government, survivor services, and the community, including you, you in this room. And I want to do that together with you. I want everyone here to join Thorn in our mission. I want you to show up at the nonprofit Impact Lounge today and ask my amazing colleagues at Thorn how you can use our technology. And I want you to go to thorn.org and learn. Learn about what these kids are going through and what technology can do to help them. And then I want you to pick up your laptop and build. Build what these kids need. There are still countless victims who are suffering, but we have the power to help them if we work together. Thank you.